and thank you for being here tonight. First of all, just start out, for those of you who could be new to the community or it's been a while since you've really been inside our schools, just recapping what school facilities we have right now. Jesse Thackeray is our newest facility, not quite open, and I'll have a slide on that in just a minute. Mount Daniel currently houses all of our kindergarten and first grade. Thomas Jefferson Elementary houses second, third, fourth, fifth, and right now they house four out of five of our pre-K classes. At Mary Ellen Henderson, we have sixth, seventh, eighth, and as of today, they have one pre-K class actually housed here. And then at George Mason is 9 through 12. In Mount Daniel, when we talk about the Mount Daniel referendum, which is really the main reason we're having the forum, but it's also just for you to understand the whole facilities piece. The referendum is to alleviate overcrowding out in Mount Daniel. When you look at Mount Daniel's growth since 2009, and one of the reasons I actually have this slide in here is there was something that was in the paper, I think it was in the news press, where it talked about, oh, we didn't grow at all. And that where that has come from is we have one grade level that had a lower growth this year, and that was kindergarten. But what you need to understand is it's still really high. If you look at 11-12, 12-13, we had a huge growth last year. So really what we got this year was still a lot of growth. It just wasn't like last year, which is actually wonderful for us because it's going to help us over the next 2 years as we're dealing with facilities issues. If you look at first grade, you still see that climb. So the goal at Mount Daniel is really to get a safe and accessible building. Right now, if we have a child who's in a wheelchair, or we have parent night, and we have a parent that's on a walker, you can't get in the front of the building. You can't go through the front entrance. We also want to be able to handle second grade. Having an early childhood building for kindergarten, first, and second grade would be wonderful for our children. We also want to accommodate growth for the next 20 years. We want to make sure that we're building a building so that we can grow with us. On this proposed plan, we had 18 classrooms, which will give us a total of 36 in that building. We will add a media center that will be brand new. They'll have a brand new gym, brand new cafeteria, art room, music room, daycare, and all of those other specialty rooms that you would have in the school. Those of you that have children there now or used to have children know that we share a cafeteria and a gym space right now. What that means when you grow is that either your children need to eat at 10:30 in the morning to eat lunch, or you can't have as much physical education as what you need because they all are in the same space. So this allows us instructionally to have a much better building as well. Actually, on the bottom of this, I want to point out too that we are returning our media center with this plan. Some of you, I'm sure, are aware that this year our media center became a classroom. So we no longer have a media center at Mount Daniel. Last year we lost our music room. So we want to get those spaces back for our children. Why should we modernize and expand? Well, first of all, Mount Daniel was built in 1952. It's a really, really old building. And it lacks adequate ADA access, which I've already mentioned. Your water fountains aren't correct. The width of the doors aren't correct. If you've ever walked down the hall of Mount Daniel, it's a ramp. It's not even safe. And I will say for many of us that when we're in that building, it's a building where you see a lot of strollers. And I know for a lot of us, you really worry about a stroller going down the ramp. It also really limits the independence that children who have special needs can have and flexibility moving around that building. And they're at an age where that really needs to be important. There are no fire sprinklers in 85% of the building. And again, this is a building that houses our youngest little ones, hardest to get out if you have a fire. The issues with the slanted hall also do not have a renovation fix. The school board has really done their homework over the last couple of years. And in 2011-12, we did some modeling to see what can we add there. Could we move second grade back? Can you look at renovating the old section? Could you go up? And that hallway does not have a fix. The most they can do for the slanted hall is they can slant, go flat, slant, go flat. That really doesn't help. So it has a lot of issues that are not fixable. And it was also built before cameras and buzzers and kind of all of the safety and security features that we want to see in the building have. And that's why our security guard is located just in the hall when you walk in the door.